What's going on, guys? It's Vusi here, Mr. Megs in the building. I'm here with another analysis video for the coming week, right? So if any of you guys here checked the video posted last week, you would have seen that most of how we had analyzed the market, most of the events we actually precipitated. Ooh, that's the first time. Most of the charts that we precipitated last week actually played out the way that the analysis showed us, you know. So that was good to see, like, most charts play out the way we actually analyze and stuff. So, like, this week we're here with another one, and like I said, I spent most of my day today looking at analyzing markets, and I did analyze quite a bunch of charts, right? But like, this video isn't meant to be like too long, and here I have my top three picks. I have my top three picks for this week, right? So this is just to help you out if you already analyzed something, so you can just like take one from this video or two. Even if you take all of them, it's cool. So the first chart we have here is Euro USD, right? So we have the Euro USD. First looked at it through a daily time frame, and I was seeing a downtrend, quite a noticeable downtrend. We've been milking this one for the longest time ever, so I think it's actually cool that it's still showing signs for potential trade. So we can never say no to milking it again, one more time, for this chart. All right. So right off the bat, I'm gonna go to the 4-hour time frame, like that. Then I wanna see a clear trend. I wanna see a point where I can actually use for the trend line, right? So just after we find the trend, or we're able to identify the trend, we need to utilize the trend line, because, you know, if you have a trend, you have a trend line. This is what we want, and I'm gonna do it like that. And see what's happening. So there's our trend line, guys. Alright. So this is the downtrend. We had our first trend movement there. Right? Up until there. We moved for quite a number of pips right there, and then I'm seeing the first reversal we had with this trend. There's our first reversal we had. So what we had to do was just wait for the reversal to be over, which was gonna be signaled by a reversal line cross, then we'd sell, right? So let me address something first before we even move further. So like I said, I first looked at this trend with the daily chart, and you can see the trend starts over here, but I'm only analyzing it here because what matters is we wanna know what price is doing at this very moment, right? I found it to not be helpful to analyze the chart for 10 years or 10 years back, or, you know, to start analyzing a chart like for the whole year or some, for the whole previous year. Like, if it doesn't tell us anything about what price is doing at this very moment, then I find it to be useful to analyze that further to the past, unless you back testing a strategy, meaning you're gonna analyze previous events and see how they play out with regards to to your trading style or trading strategy, then yeah, I would advise you to backtest using past data. But in the case where we're looking to trade for the coming week, it's not really necessary. So this is why my trend line started there. All right, so we had first selling pressure there when the price went down. Then as we went up, we made a lower high, which was the first signal that we're in a downtrend. And then after that, we had more selling pressure downwards, right? And this time there was more momentum this time around than there was this side, right? So what had happened after that is we went to make a lower low, which was there. So at this lower low, we went to make a lower high again. This was the previous high and this is the current high. So now what I was expecting was that the price would go down. If a candlestick failed to actually break this trend line, then it would mean that the price is supposed to go down. So already we was expecting the price to go down, but then on Friday we actually saw candlesticks to the upside, right? So with that in mind, now we are in a reversal phase. I'll confirm we are in a reversal phase because you can draw this by connecting the two lows like that. And I'm gonna move my trend line just a bit further than that. We are in a reversal phase because if you can look at what the price is doing now, we're not moving up, we're not moving down, we're just moving sideways, right? So I'm either expecting the start of a new trend if we cross here, right? Or a continuation of the trend if we cross our reversal line, right? So at this moment, like, it's all just a matter of waiting to see what the market does next, right? I told you I'm a firm believer of reacting to the markets instead of predicting what's going to happen next, right? So until the market shows a sign, then we're only waiting to see what will happen. But I think this will be an interesting week to see how this one plays out, right? So let's move on to the next pair we have is USD CAD. There we go. So I'm gonna start with a daily chart for this one also. I'm just gonna clear out this past trend lines that I hadn't removed. Yeah. So this is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing an uptrend on this one, right? I'm seeing an uptrend because why? Because I'm seeing a low here, a high, a higher low, a higher high, a higher up until there. Everything is just going higher. The highs are getting higher, the lows are getting higher. Alright? So let's draw our trend line since we have a trend in place. We're gonna have our trend line from the first low like this, right? But that means we only have to adjust it, and let me tell you why. Because you see, like, where the price is at right now, that's where the price is at, and this is where the trend line is at. If you heard when I said I analyze so I can understand what's happening to price at this very moment. So having a trend line this far from the price really doesn't aid me with anything in terms of what the price is doing. So instead of starting my trend line instead of making this my first low, I'm gonna make this my first low. So I'm gonna draw the trend line now using this low, and we'll see if that can tell us anything about the price. And voila. All right. So this is what's going on right now. We are in this uptrend, right? Let's go back to the 4 hours. Now with the 4 hour time frame, we'll see that this trend has been quite a strong trend since late February till now, right? But then now what we have to do is we need to identify and observe what the price is doing, right? So since this is an uptrend, right, I'm seeing an uptrend, and then what I'm seeing here is a high and lower high, right? So this can tell me that we're actually in a consolidating market, because if you look at this low and a higher low, and then we have a high and a lower high, so the market is at this moment still within the trend but moving sideways, all right? Meaning two things can only happen if we join the highs like that. Then we can see that we're in a flag kind of pattern, right? So two things can happen here. The market will either come down here and reject to actually break this trend line, and then we'll actually break the reversal line. And when we break the reversal line, that means we're going to continue with the trend. Or we'll break the trend line, the market will start going down then, meaning we'll go from an uptrend to a downtrend. So unless we break the reversal line, then we'll see how to actually trade a new face of the market if we do go in a downtrend. But as of now, I'm just waiting to see if we'll break the reversal line so we can continue to make new highs, right? So that's the USD CAD. And then last but not least, we have the USD ZAR, right? I'm not a big USD ZAR trader, but I'm a big fan of a good trading opportunity, right? So what I actually saw with this one, I'm just gonna wait for my trend line to actually, for my charts to actually load. But yeah, what I'm actually, I have for you guys is USD ZAR. So now with the USD ZAR, I'm seeing the first low, a high, the first high, a higher low, and then a higher high. So I know it's an uptrend, right? So I need a trend line for this uptrend. I'm gonna start it like that. Alright, so I have my uptrend there. Right, we had the first reversal that occurred there, right? And then as expected, when the price broke the reversal line, we went to make a new high, right? So now what's happening with this pair here though has caught my attention, because the last 4 hour candlestick broke the trend line, right? So you know, like, the market has this times where it might do a fake out, which is another way of like triggering either sellers or buyers to enter a market when it's the wrong time. So I'm gonna wait to see if if the price is gonna push down, but I'm gonna only enter at a lower high, because I need confirmation. You always need confirmation to enter a market. Don't just enter based on what you think without any visual confirmation. So I still have My reversal line for this one, because it's very possible that the price might still take a turn and break to the push to the upside of this chart. But then we're keeping an open mind. If this pair continues going down, then there's a plan which we might have to execute for a downtrend, but we'll need a second low as confirmation. But if we do see bullish momentum and then we are able to break the reversal line, then we only gonna buy into the buying pressure of this chart, right? So we had the Euro USD, which we're waiting for. It's in a consolidating phase. It's a reversal. We want to see if it's gonna pick a side, right? But we prepared for a downtrend. And then we have the USD CAD, which is an uptrend. It's also reversing, but it's also in a reversal, by the way. So we prepared for an uptrend, but if it does break to the downside, then we'll take action and see how we can go for that. And then we have the USD ZAR. This one is quite interesting. We'll have to see which side it actually goes also. So I hope this video helps, guys. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. Smash the like button if you found it helpful. Blow up the comments, and I'll see you on the next one, guys. Thanks.